strength. This song says, we bow down and we worship you now for how great and how awesome is he. Holy is the Lord God Almighty. The earth is filled with his glory. Let's sing this morning like the earth is filled with his glory, like we're alive because he lives. Sing it now, church. We stand. Sing.
We stand and lift up our hands
for the joy.
For the joy of the Lord is our strength.
We bow down.
We bow down and worship him now for how great and how awesome he is.
Sing it, church. Ho!
Holy is the Lord God Almighty. The earth is filled with his glory. Holy is the Lord God Almighty. And the earth is filled with his glory. Holy is the Lord God Almighty. The earth is filled with his glory. Holy is the Lord God Almighty.
The earth is filled
with his glory.
The glory of God. You can look out these windows and see the glory of God. He's alive in everything. He created everything. And if we're not seeing him, it's not because he's not visible. It's because we're missing him. So let's focus on him this morning. Let's not miss him. He's holy forever. Sing, church, worship him now. A thousand
generations falling down in worship to sing the song of ages to the Lamb.
All who've gone before us.
All who've gone before us. And all who will believe will sing the song of ages to the Lamb.
Your name's the highest.
Your name is the highest. the highest, your name is the greatest, your name stands above.
Come on, think about them,
all thrones and dominions, all powers and positions, your name stands above them all, and the angels cry, holy, all creation cries, holy, you are lifted high, holy, holy forever.
Come on, sing the second verse. This is us this morning. Focus on it. Sing.
If you've been forgiven.
Come on, folks.
And if you've been redeemed, then sing the song forever to the Lamb.
Are you focusing on what the song is saying? If you walk in freedom,
if you walk in freedom, and if you bear his name, then sing the song forever to the Lamb. We'll sing it forever. We'll sing the song forever and amen. And the angels cry, holy, the highest, your name is the greatest, your name stands above them all.
Focus on it.
All thrones and dominions, all powers and positions, your name stands above them all.
Come on, sing it like you believe.
Your name is the highest, your name the greatest, your name stands above them all. All thrones and dominions, all powers and positions, your name, it stands above. And the angels cry, the angels cry, holy, all creation cries. You will always be holy. You will always be holy. You will always be holy. Holy forever.
Come on, sing like you believe it one more time. Come on.
You will always be holy. You will always be perfect and awesome and holy. You will always be holy, holy forever.
Let's give God the praise that He's holy. Let's worship Him because He's holy and because we can be holy like Him. Let's praise Him.
Good morning. Welcome to Crossroads Baptist Church, our Sunday morning service. And first and foremost, we want to say Happy Mother's Day to all the mothers out there in place and online. Happy Mother's Day. But we're here to worship the Lord. He will always be holy. Amen. Holy forever. Please join me as we open our service in prayer. Our Father, we thank you so much for the privilege we have to gather in your house and to worship you. We're thankful that we serve a holy God, an awesome God, a loving God, a caring God, a forgiving God. And we just pray that you meet with us. Pray that you forgive us of any sin, remove any distractions, and help us to focus on your word as we worship and through the preaching. We pray for our pastor, Lord. We pray that you use him in a mighty way. We sure do thank you for him and how he loves the book and how he preaches the book, and help us as believers to take the book and apply it as best as we can. We pray if there's anyone here who hasn't trusted you as their Lord and Savior, that they come to full knowledge of that today. We love you. We thank you. We pray all these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Dance in your presence.
this place. I just wanna be with you. I just wanna be with you, my King of glory, King of glory. Please fill this place. I just wanna be with you. God, I just wanna be with you.
I just want to be with you. Is that your prayer this morning? Amen. Nothing else matters. We just want to be with him. Amen. We need him in this place. Well, we'd like to take a moment to welcome our guests and visitors and those who are joining us online. If you are a first-time guest or visitor this morning, you have not received a welcome card, would you please slip your hand up? One of our ushers in the back would love to get one of those to you. We'd love for you to fill it out so we can acknowledge you and thank you for being with us in the service this morning. So we don't have any visitor cards this morning. So if you are a church member, we ask that you please stand. If you are a guest or visitor, we ask that you remain seated. Church members, let's greet our guests and visitors and thank them for being with us in the service this morning.
We serve a way maker, and he's real. He's a promise keeper. He's the light in the darkness, but he's my God. That's just who he is. So if you need him to move this morning, something in your life, just sing to him. Just tell him you believe. Worship him, because he's a way maker. You are here moving in our midst. Sing it, church.
You are here. Moving in our midst, I worship you. I worship you.
Come on, just focus on it.
You are here, working in this place. I worship you. I worship you.
Sing it, you are here.
You are here, moving in our midst. I worship you. I worship you.
Working in this place.
You are here, working in this place. I worship you. I worship you.
Come on, church, sing it. Waymaker.
Waymaker, miracle work, promise keep, light in the darkness, my God. That is who you are.
That's my favorite one, is my God. It makes it personal. Come on, church.
Waymaker, miracle work, promise keep, light in the darkness, my God. That is who you are.
Come on, you are here, say.
You are here, touching every heart.
You just touch.
I worship you.
God, I worship
you. Made a way for you, church. Has he ever made a way? Waymaker, miracle work, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God. That is who you
even
are.
When I can't see it, come on, worship, sing it now.
Even when I can't see it, your work. Even when I can't feel it, your work. And never stop, never stop working. Never stop.
Come on, like you believe.
Even when I can't see it, you're working. Even when I can't feel it, you're working. You never stop. You never stop working. You never stop. You never stop.
Come on, church, say it.
Even when I can't see it, you're working. Even when I can't feel it.
Put your arms out like this, and when I throw the ball, you catch it. You ready? Here we go.
Good job. All right. Hey. Let's go, team. Come on. Good job. Good job. Go! Go! That's my boy.
How's that?
Tight.
That's how it's supposed to be. You want to be the one giving the hit, not taking it.
Go!
Back on. Come on, come on.
Facing off against the Hornets.
Yeah! That's what I'm talking
yards.
About. Did you see that? That's a late hit.
Touchdown, Wildcats.
like this in your senior year as a national champion has to be an incredible feeling.
It's unbelievable.
Is there anything you'd like to say to the folks back home?
Actually, there's somebody I want to give a special shout out to. Hi, Mom!
Blessing. We certainly appreciate those who took into account that these folks in our lives are so special that we have a holiday that we celebrate, the people that we celebrate every day. Amen. And we are so thankful for all of the moms and the wives represented here in Crossroads Baptist Church. We're thankful for those moms and wives who are no longer with us. We're thankful for their lasting impact and their legacy that continues on. And I know that Mother's Day for a number of you is a bittersweet occasion as you remember your mother, remember that one who played such a huge role in your life. And so while others may enjoy the privilege of having their moms here on earth with them, for you, it perhaps strikes a chord of sorrow and of grief. But we sorrow not as those that have no hope, because we know one day we're going to get a chance to spend eternity with them. Amen. And so for all of the moms that are not here and those that are missing them, Crossroads Baptist Church wants you to know how much we care about you and we love you. For those who still have your moms with you, I think all of these whose moms are no longer here would say, you better cherish your mom while you have her. You just never know. Life is no guarantee. And just that fast, it can be gone. We thank God for the gift of life. I'd like all of our ladies, all of our moms and wives to stand at this time, all over the building, in the balcony too. All the moms and wives to stand up, would you? All over the building. Come on, let's make them feel real special. Come on, make them feel real special. Yes, 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 yes. Special folks around here. I want to say a special happy Mother's Day to two women in my life. The first is my wife. I certainly thank the Lord for my wife, Bethany, standing beside me, all that she does for our children. They have had the privilege of having the best mom in all of the world. And those of us that are dads understand the job may look easy till we have to do it. Amen. And there's just something about what a mom means in the life of a child that's irreplaceable and indescribable. So Bethany, thank you for the mom you are to our children and the wife you are to me. Would you help me in thanking her today for being number one? Say how much I love you. And then let me say a special happy Mother's Day to my mom, who's not here this morning. I mentioned Wednesday, she battles this inner ear problem and the range. So I want to say, I didn't just win a national championship, but I am who I am by the grace of God and my mom. So like that fella just did a few moments ago, hi, Mom. I sure love you and appreciate you. And I hope from where you are that God will give you some relief and give you some comfort and that God will heal you of that issue and get you back here with us. But where you are today with Dad beside you, I hope you have a wonderful, happy Mother's Day. Thank you for your investment and impact in my life. Can you thank my mom for today with me? Ladies, we have a gift for all of you, and rather than making all of you march forward and get it outside to the left at the table is a gift from my wife to you on Mother's Day. So I hope that every one of you will stop by the welcome table and get that gift and know how much we appreciate you. We had breakfast earlier this morning, and I think there's some leftovers there. I know there are, because some of y'all during the handshaking time were getting your gift and getting your muffin. How many of you know nothing is better than a gift and a muffin, all right? So I hope you'll stop by and get that, and we want to be able to move through the service and give you as much time together as family. So I want to have a word of prayer over all of our moms and wives today on the floor and in the balcony,
And thank you so much and wish you a happy Mother's Day. And then we'll get to all these wonderful, good-looking hats. I tell you, y'all look so good today, I'm telling you. And we're excited about that. But let me have a word of prayer for all of you today. Father, thank you for these wives and moms. Thank you for what they mean. Thank you, Lord, for their impact, for their drive, for their resilience. We thank you, God, for their survival mode that kicks in and seems to make them stronger than anything on planet Earth. We thank you for the praying mamas and grandmamas here today. And for all of these children and men and others who today can say, I'm here today because my mama prayed me through. Grandmama prayed for me. We thank you, Lord. I pray, God, you touch the hearts of those who are hurting, missing their moms today. And we pray, God, that you would give them a peace and a grace and an anticipation in the meantime that one day we'll be able to spend eternity together. We love you and we bless you. We magnify your name and we ask that you would keep giving these moms long life, prosperity, and favor and the impact they have on us and the whole world that none of us could ever describe. We bless you, we magnify you, and we ask your blessing on the rest of the service. In Jesus' name, amen. Give a hand to all these moms today. Come on. All right. Ladies, y'all look so good in those hats. Come on, guys, give these ladies a hand for these hats today. Now, somebody asked me for a group picture, so ladies, come on up if you got a hat on, if you can get up here. Come on. Come on up here. We got a whole platform and a choir loft. We want to see y'all. Come on up here. Yes, you know where the platform is. You're up on it every week. If you need the rails, there's one on the side. We can't have you falling and suing us on Mother's Day. Yep. Yes. Up the side. Let's go up the side with the rail. Yes. Don't they look good? Give them a hand, fellas. They look real good. Coming from the balcony. All right. Where are our deacons at? Wave your hand, deacons. Wave your hand. Yeah, there they are. Spread out so y'all can see, deacons. You're getting ready to judge. Look at Brother Jefferson. I can't judge. If I don't pick my wife, I won't have nowhere to go home to. Well, that's why we're doing it. See what you're going to do. Take your time. Let's get these choir lights on. Whoa, light them up. Give it up for these hatted ladies today. Don't they look good? Get you a good picture. Hold on, one more. The pastor did it. They're looking. Y'all need them to stay. You got your top three? All right, let's let the ladies start walking down. Keep watching, guys. Come on, ladies. Come on down. Get your good look. It's not an easy choice. Come on up here, deacons. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Yeah, we put you on the spot. Come on here, come on, come on, come on, come on. Here they come marching. They let you off. Huh? What you say? You don't want no parts of that. You voting for the one beside you. Yeah, come on up here. They represent you. Brother Jefferson said he want me to know, say to tell y'all that all the hats look good, all the hats. Why don't y'all want to stay here while I announce the winners? Why y'all? Give a hand to the deacons on their last Sunday as deacons here at Crossroads Baptist Church. It was a good ride, fellas. It was a good ride. We only got Deacon Tibbs left. He's the only one left. So. Well, here's where they are. Here's where they are. They all wanted to pick their wives, and they felt like y'all would throw eggs at them if they picked their wives. And they mentioned my wife. I figured y'all would vote me out if I picked my wife. So here's how their order has come. Third place goes to, drum roll, Miss Marie Hall. Stand up. Thank you. Second place goes to Miss Linda Banks. Only to be outdone as the first place by her mother, Christine Dawkins. Stand up, please, Miss Dawkins. And we love Miss Dawkins around here. She was telling me, I can't remember what you told me last time, but the doctor told you you weren't going to live past when? And how long ago was that? 31 years. And she's still here. Thank you, Lord. Come on, let's give God the praise. Amen. Amen. It ain't so till God says so. Amen. And we have we have a prize for all of you that my wife has. It's a hat stand for all of you, for all three places, and a special gift in addition to the hat stand for the winner. Let's give all our ladies a round of applause today. What a blessing. What a blessing. Isn't it good to come to church where we can have a good time? We certainly appreciate it. In just a moment, we're going to take our offering and have our message, and I promise you, we will not be long. We want to give these ladies a wonderful time together. But it's a fun time to get together and celebrate our ladies here at Crossroads Baptist Church. And you all are just beautiful inside and out. I want you to be in prayer for one of our young ladies. Pray for Taja. Taja went to the hospital just a couple days ago. She was having some bad, bad headaches, debilitating, really. Just she could do nothing. Her mom was with her. They took her to the hospital by ambulance. And she's been there in Alexandria Hospital for a couple of days. Taja's goal is to leave from Alexandria Hospital to Mexico, where she is in contact with a clinic with specialized treatment who is aware of her condition, and they want to treat her. And the goal in Alexandria Hospital is to get her to the point that she can go straight from there to the airport to Mexico. She's dealing with some swelling on the brain. They're controlling the swelling, but she's also dealing with some metastasis where the cancer has gone elsewhere. And Taja told me specifically, she said, I want the church praying. And so I'm going to ask every single one of you to pray every day for Taja. Thank God for Mexico. Thank God for Alexandria. Thank God for Mayo. Thank God for clinics. Thank God for chemo. Thank God for radiation. But we know where healing comes from. Healing comes from Almighty God. And so you pray for her. We had a wonderful time. She's in an unbelievable spirit. It's mind-boggling to hear her talk. She's just laughing and talking. She looks like she just left a hairdresser. We told her, she said, I didn't fix my hair right, Pastor. We said, looks like you just, I mean, she just looks picture perfect with a great spirit. And the doctors she's had people come in the room. They're crying for her. And she's stopping them. Say, listen to me. God writes my story, you know. And she told me at the beginning of this, she wanted her life to be a testimony to the doctors. And it has. And so we're just praying that God would touch. God took the cancer away before. God can take it away again. There's nothing our God cannot do. And so we're praying, and we are praying. So in just a little bit, when we pray over the offering, we'll ask whoever prays to lift up a special prayer for her, that God would strengthen her and heal her. And practically speaking, get her to the point that she can leave the States and go where she believes. And somebody said, I don't know if Mexico is the right place. We didn't ask you. And so, seriously, you know, you answer when you ask the question. If you're not asked, you shouldn't be answering. And unsolicited advice is often viewed as criticism. So sometimes just best to let God do what he's doing. And we know that he's in control, and you know, God is a healer, but he does use doctors, and everybody's got an opinion. But ultimately, I told her, you got to go with what you believe is right for your medical team and the choices you can make, and everybody else, don't worry about them, because it's your body, all right? So we're praying for her that God would give strength and grace, and God knows what he's doing. Amen. And while God is moving and working in those that are sick here at Crossroads Baptist Church and healing time and time again, he's also blessing our church with wonderful miracles of life by way of our pregnant moms that are giving birth to children. And we are so excited about that. I mentioned this past Wednesday, congratulations to Deontay and Bethany, and we are so excited about the baby boy that was born Monday morning. If those of you weren't here Wednesday, Monday morning in the wee hours of the morning, Kyrie Santiago Hollum. So let's congratulate them again. We are so excited. And he is good looking. He never behaved so well than when he was in my arms. It was just like that. He, I, and God, we just all just connected at that moment. Hand him to my wife, hand him to my daughter, hand him back to my daughter-in-law, handing him to Bethany's mom. Bethany, he just squealed and cried and everything. Took him back. It's just peace that passes all understanding. So So you just pray that God gives him the grace to be able to keep on going on when he's not in my arms, and that he's able to move. But Bethany is doing well. We thank the Lord for her progress, and we give God the glory for it. And then just a couple of days ago, we give congratulations to Krista Reddick. Krista and Cephas, we're so excited for them, and we are thrilled. There you see the picture of Kyla Alea Reddick. And we want to make sure we get the names right. Get it right so we help the grandparents get it right too. All right? I mean, it's just the way you spell these names, it's hard to, you know, it's hard to figure it out. You know, we just give them nicknames, right? But we thank the Lord for this. It's a big baby. And we are so thrilled for Cephas and Krista, their first child, and it's a gift of life. So let's congratulate these folks and thank the Lord. What God is doing. Keep them coming. Yes. Let's just keep growing the church. Amen. From the inside, we are blessing. We're blessed around here, and we certainly thank the Lord for God's goodness and grace. Thank you for praying for my wife and me as the men come forward. We appreciate your prayers. We were down in North Augusta on Monday and Tuesday, had just a wonderful time. Last Sunday, we were headed out, and you prayed for us, and God watched over us, got us in safely. Had a wonderful crowd of over 1,000 people, souls saved, lives changed. For those of you that tuned in, I'm always humbled by those of you that pray for your pastor. You continue to lift me up and lift all of those up that are engaged in the work of God. Listen, people need the Lord everywhere. And we're burdened in these last days. If you're looking at the news, what's happening in the Middle East, everything that's happening, Jesus is coming soon. I really believe it. Whatever we're going to do, we have to do for the Lord. So let's trust and believe that God knows what he's doing, and he's continuing to work in us and through us for God's glory. Amen. Let's have a word of prayer. We thank the Lord for the faithful giving of God's people. Each of us pays our tithes, gives our offerings for the work and ministry of God's local New Testament church. Freely, a loving God has given to us, and freely we give back to him. For the Lord loveth a cheerful giver. Let's give cheerfully to the Lord, knowing we cannot outgive God. Let's ask God's blessing on the giving today, and please make sure in your prayer that you lift up Taja before the Lord and everything else that's going on, that God would move in a special way. Let's ask, if we could, Brother Pesor, to ask God's blessing on the giving. Yes. Amen. I'd like you to be in prayer for Cece Oates. We got a text early this morning that her mom passed away to go and be with the Lord. And we've been praying for Cece's mom for a long time. And I know that this is a heavy heart on Mother's Day, on Maya, their daughter's birthday, and Marcus's mom passed away between this year and last year too. So they're carrying heavy hearts. Let's lift him up before the Lord. Aren't you glad he's a burden bearer? Amen. And let's continue to ask God's blessing. Pascal's going to come sing an appropriate song for all of us. We get ready for preaching time. How many of you know, regardless of what we face, we are blessed? I say, how many of you know we are blessed? Let's worship the Lord as he sings and be reminded we're blessed to be a blessing. I am blessed.
head to rest. I feel you near me. You serve me when I'm weary. Oh Lord, for all the worst and all the best, I am blessed. Now all along the road less traveled, I have called and I have run. I have wandered through the wind and rain until I found the sun. The watching eyes, they ask me why I walk this narrow way. I will gladly give the reason for this hope I have today. Yeah. You soothe me when I'm weary. Oh Lord, for all the worst and all the best, I am blessed. You've given me joy, you've given me love, you've given me strength when I want to give up. Oh, you came from heaven to rescue my soul. This is the reason I know.
Somebody give God the praise if you know you're blessed today. Amen.
So blessed. We give God the glory for it. And may God help us to show a world just how blessed we are. And they're looking for blessings in all the wrong places. And we know who the blesser is. And may God help us bless so that others can know where we get our blessings from. Could I give you just a few thoughts from Exodus? Chapter 1. Exodus chapter 1. How many of you have a reservation today? All right. Busiest restaurant day of the year. So let's make sure you can get there. Some have already got to get there. I understand. Y'all wish I set my reservation for 12, don't you? Pastor, I booked your reservation, pay for your family to eat at 11:30. Come in here, open in prayer and close in prayer, and we'll get you out the building and be right behind you. Our reservation 11:45. Exodus 1. Look at verse 22. Now I'm going to give you my thought for today, and then I'm going to give you the outline, and then I'll let you go home and think about it, okay? Verse 22 of Exodus 1, are you there? And Pharaoh charged all his people, saying, every son that is born you shall cast into the river, and every daughter you shall save, what? Live. Verse 1 of chapter 2. And there went a man of the house of, where were the Levites? Yeah. And took to wife a daughter of, and the woman conceived and bare a, You know what we do with sons, according to verse 22. And when she saw them, he was a goodly child. She did what? Hid him 3 months. And when she could not longer hide him, she took for him in the ark of what? Bulrushes. And daubed it with slime and pitch. Put the child therein, and she laid it in the flags by the river's brink. And his sister stood afar off to wit what would be done to him. Who's his sister? Go ahead with y'all bad self. Y'all know it's an old Bible reading church. And the daughter of who? Came down to wash herself at the river, and her maidens walked along by the riverside. And when she saw the ark among the flags, she sent her maid to what? Fetch it. And when she had opened it, she saw the what? Child. And behold, the babe, if he was weeping, that means he was still alive. And she had compassion on him, wouldn't you? And said, this is one of the what? Hebrews children. Yeah. Then said his sister to Pharaoh's daughter, shall I go call thee a nurse of the Hebrew women that she may nurse the child for thee? And Pharaoh's daughter said to her, what? Go. And the maid went and called the child's who? Jochebed. And Pharaoh's daughter said unto her, take this child away and nurse it for me, and I will give thee thy wages. And the woman took the child and nursed it. And the child, what? And brought him to Pharaoh's daughter, and he became her what? And she called his name what? You ever heard of him? And she said, because I drew him out of the water. Let the church say amen. For a few moments today, I want to preach on this subject. Mothers who let go and let God. Mothers who let go. Talk to me. Mothers who let go. Father, in the name of Jesus, cleanse me, empty me, fill me, use me in Jesus' name. Amen. You may be seated. Love is something that is masqueraded at times. It's perpetrated at times. It's disguised. It is paraded at times by people who have no idea what it is because they've heard about it. They've wanted to emulate it. They've thought they possess it, but when the going got tough, you found out what they had wasn't love. It was something that was masquerading as love. See, one of the attributes of love that gets obscured in all that the world seems to parade is the aspect of sacrifice. Love sacrifices. See, we love does give, and love does go, and love does buy, and love does spoil, and love does cherish, and love does lavish. And by the way, you can give without loving, but you can't love without giving. Can I get an amen? But love sacrifices. And in Exodus chapter 1 and 2, we're going to find that a mother's love takes her to do something that she perhaps never contemplated doing when she was a little girl. Yet love demanded, watch this now, in order to save her son, she had to give up her son. And I would say to all of us who've been on the receiving end of a mother's love, you and I would do ourselves good today to pause and think of not just all the gifts we got, not just all the hugs we received, not just all the kisses that we were on the receiving end of, not just all of the wonderful words and the wonderful times and the wonderful gestures and the wonderful meals and the wonderful baked goods that only mama can cook and fix. I would call us to be mindful today of the times that a mother has had to get to the point to where she couldn't fix it herself. She couldn't change it herself. She couldn't solve it herself. There wasn't enough money in her bank. There wasn't enough intellect in her mind. There wasn't enough resources in her possession. She came to the point in time in her life where in order to save her child, she had to give up her child. And then when she got to the end of her rope, she came to where every mom must come to let go and let God. In a dangerous reality, she She let go and let God. Verse 22 tells us there's a wicked authority in charge. Pharaoh's in charge. And he's putting a woeful attack on all of the boys. Listen to me. There's an attack on the young men. He doesn't want the young men. He's okay with the, he doesn't want the young, because the leadership in that country would be on the young men. So he says, kill all the young. Ladies and gentlemen, we're not living in a day with a Pharaoh that says, throw all the boys in the river. But we are living in a day where there is an attack on young men. Attack on the leadership potential in our country, an attack on young men. By the way, that attack manifests itself in the book of Daniel where he tried to get all the young men to be eunuchs. I won't go there that long today, but to be eunuchs meant they would ultimately be sexless. And here we are today in a day and age where we can't figure out our gender today, and there's an attack on masculinity. There's an attack on manhood. There's an attack on distinction, because you can't get the work of God done if you bypass God's order. Can I get an amen? And so there's a worldly agenda at play. This is when the woman lets go and lets God. Not when she's living in the nicest neighborhood. Not when her zip code is Googled as number one where to raise children. She has to let go and let God when a wicked man is on the throne who has already foregone his conclusion to kill the boys. Number two, she makes a decisive rationale. In the midst of all of this, there's a miraculous birth. She has a baby. When? She has a baby when there is wickedness going on. Could I tell you, we just celebrated two moms that had babies this past week. Could I tell you, they had babies where there's wickedness going on. Listen to me. Listen, you can't wait to get pregnant for the world to get right. It ain't going to get right till Jesus gets it right. That means if you have a child, you're going to have a child in the midst of wickedness. This miraculous birth showed also some manifested beauty. She said, he was a goodly child. She looked at him. He's so good to look at. He's such a handsome boy. And she knew that the better he looked, the more he was threatened. Can I tell you something? The more our children have going for them, the more the world and the devil want to destroy them. And so there's a maternal burden inside of her. She hid him. She hid him. She hid him. This motivated block to protect him or to shield him. That's what that block was. It was hiding him to make sure that nobody could find him. We don't know where she hid him. We don't know where in the house she hid him. But here's what she was thinking. If the Pharaoh and his people find out about my boy, they're going to kill me. Listen, isn't it something about a mama that goes into survival mode? She does whatever she, nobody has to tell her. Nobody has to teach her. Nobody has to prime her. Nobody has to push her. When her babies are under attack, she does whatever it takes. Notice the desperate resolution of this mom. Under serious pressure, when she couldn't hide her baby anymore, the Bible says she made special preparation. I don't have time to talk about bulrushes and the kind of bushes that she used and the slime and the pitch that she used. If I had time, I'd talk about what this substance was. But in so many words, could I tell you, she not only put her boy in something, but she put her boy in something that water could not penetrate. That's what that slime was, the mud of that. Here's what she's saying. I've got to give my child up, and I'm going to have to build somewhat like an ark for him, and I've got to build some kind of a box, in so many words, or a basket that I'm going to put him in. But if I set my child in the water, I got to make sure that even though the boy is in the water can't get in. Somebody help me preach. Here's what she says. She says, if I got to send him out into the world, I want to make sure that I put him in the world, but I don't let the world get in him. If I drop him off to school, I want to make sure he goes to school, but they don't school him. Listen to me. I'm saying, a mama says, if I've got to give up my child, I'm going to make sure I put my child in the safest place that my, aren't some of you boys and girls ought to give God the praise that your mama, yes, she sent you to school. Yes, she sent you to this place. Yes, she sent you to that. But she made sure you were insulated. Make sure you were protected. Daubed you with slime and pitch and bulrushes. Just make sure that I'm sending him somewhere dangerous, but I'm going to make sure that although he's around danger, that danger don't get him. And the Bible says she placed him. Notice what the scripture says. The Bible says she laid it in the flags. This is the more shallow section of the water where flags were, where there was greenery, where there were perhaps grass there, where, in other words, she wanted him to get to the place where he would move which way the water moved, but where he would most likely get stopped up in those flags and be found by somebody. In other words, she didn't just put him in the water where he rolled off into the deep. She put him among the flag. Here's what she's saying. I'm going to let him go, and I'm going to let God listen to me. I'm going to make sure he's in something that will protect him, but I'm going to set him somewhere where somebody will. By the way, listen to me. You can't save your children, but you ought to put them somewhere where they can get saved. Listen to me. You can't call your children to preach, but you ought to put them somewhere. Somebody, God give us mamas who put their children among the flags. I'm not going to throw them to the wolves. I'm not going to feed them to the devil. I can't watch them everywhere they go. I can't be with them every place they attend, but I can at least set them in a place where the current will take them in position to somebody that can help them. Her steadfast persuasion, she had to trust God. The sister stood back scared. You notice the scripture never says mama stood back scared? There had to be something in her mind that goes, I'm giving up my child. But listen, you know what she understood? God gave me this baby. Come on now. God, watch this now. And as much as I love my baby, God loves my baby more. And I've just got to believe that God knows who Pharaoh is. God knows what the decree is. God knows what everything's going on. But listen, when she looked at that baby, she had to know in her heart, there's something special about this boy. God's got a plan for my son. And I'm not just going to give up and throw my, listen to me, parent. Listen to me, mamas. Don't throw your hand in the air because the world's gotten so bad and the sin's gotten so wicked in the devil. I just can't do it. It's too hard. The devil's just going to take them. I might as well not fight. No. You build your ark. You get your slime. You get your pitch. You put it among the flags and you let God do the rest. Notice the definite reward and I'm done. She did what she could. I said she did what she could. Isn't that what raising children is? You do what you can. Divine providence. Guess who happened to be washing herself where the baby was floating? Not just an Egyptian woman. I'm talking about the daughter of Pharaoh. Y'all must not know who Pharaoh was. He's the one that made the law. Somebody help me preach. That's providence. Listen. When your performance has reached its peak, God's providence steps in. Somebody missed that. Put that on the quotes. Listen, I said, when your performance has reached its peak, that's when God's providence steps in. But wait a minute. Sometimes God's providence doesn't step in because our performance has not peaked. Listen to me. Are you listening to me now? Jesus took his time getting to where Lazarus was, and Jesus knew Lazarus was going to die. The sisters met him when he showed up and said, if you'd been here earlier, Lazarus would not have died. Jesus said, y'all think resurrection is an event. Resurrection is a person. I am the resurrection and the life. Y'all worried about when I got here. You ought to be glad that I am here, because no matter when I come, I may not come when you want me, but I'll be there right on time. I'm an on-time God. And there he goes, walking to the tomb where Lazarus has been buried. Not one day, not 2 days, not 3 days, but 4 days, wrapped in grave clothes and a stankin'. They're gathered around the tomb, weeping and wailing and crying. And then Jesus is getting ready to raise Lazarus back to life, right? Nobody on planet Earth can call Lazarus. They can call him, but he ain't going to get up. Nobody can call him, and he actually gets up, but that man. But before he does what he does, he looks at those around him and says, move the stone. Move the stone. Why? Why? Because my providence will step in when your performance has peaked. Y'all didn't get me here just to move a stone when y'all can move it. Y'all brought me here to raise a body. I'll do what I do when you do what you can do. Now you move the stone and stand back and see the salvation of. Listen to me, folks. I'll tell you why God showed up for this mama. She peaked her performance so the providence of God could step in. And out of all the people, the who's who daughter showed up. Notice the distinct preservation. She found a baby intact. Amen. All of us know sometimes God uses other people to pour into our children in ways we can't. But our job is to make sure they have a child to pour into. Thank God she found a box with a baby in it. And thank God she found a baby that was still crying, because the baby had a mama to make sure the box was lined with insulation so the water couldn't get her baby. Thank God for every mama that's lined the box. Somebody help me preach this morning. The mama that's lined it with prayers on her knees, that's lined it with food in your sack, that's lined it with training that you couldn't get from school, that's lined it with investment that you can never get back, that's lined it with them talks, with them whoopings that just line the box to make sure that when you showed up at the next level in life, that somebody was ready to pour into you, you actually was somebody ready to get poured into. The delightful privilege is that she needs someone to nurse the baby. And the daughter says, should we get somebody? Come on, you can't make this stuff up. And guess who she goes and gets? The mama. Somebody say, the mama. Listen to me. Come on. Listen. See, when you let go and let God gives back. I said, when you let go and let God gives back. She gave her son up because if she kept him, he would have died. She gave her son up and kept him alive, and God gave him back to her to wean. And by the way, this could have been several years in those days to wean. We're not just talking about a couple of days. She got it. Wait a minute now. She not only gave her the delightful privilege of raising child, but she gave her distributed provision. Not only am I going to let you raise your own child, I'm going to pay you for raising your own child. Now, when you mamas tell me when you get paid for raising your child. There was a destined purpose in this boy. They called him Moses. Y'all ain't never heard of Moses? He wrote the first 5 books of the Bible. Amen. That boy would grow up and later become a deliverer. That old stuttering boy would go into Pharaoh and look at him square in the face, and God said, let my people go. He'd carry a rod that would turn into a snake, get picked up by the tail and turn back into a rod. By the hands of Moses, 10 plagues would be done. God would use Moses to strike up darkness on the Egyptian side while it stayed light on the Israelite side. God would use Moses to turn water into blood. God would use Moses to send frogs and tell the frogs when to go back. God would use Moses to send lice to send death among the cattle. God would use Moses to send flies, and then God would use Moses to go into Pharaoh at the 10th plague to kill all the firstborn, and to use Moses to tell the people to put blood on the post so that when the death angel comes to your house and he sees blood on the post, he sees the blood and passes on. You ever heard of Passover? That's where it comes from, when God passed over them. And there's only one way when you stand before Jesus that he'll pass over, throwing you into hell. It won't be your last name, your church membership, your denomination, how much money you gave on the tithing record. He'll only pass over you if he sees the blood. Saint Moses led them out of Egypt, part of the Red Sea. Water from the rock, bitter water, sweet manna from heaven, quail from heaven. Yes. There is no Moses to deliver if there is no mother who lets go and lets God. Aren't you glad that Jochebed wasn't the last mom that let go and let God? Thank God for all the moms in this day and age, in a different context, but with the same principle, who have made up their mind, as bad as the world is, we'll do what we can and let God do the rest. Let go and let God. Father, in Jesus' name, would you touch your people? All over the building today, if you say, Pastor, I'm saved, I'm going to heaven, I know it, would you raise your hand? Saved, I'm going to heaven, and I know it. Put your hands down. I'd like to talk to all the ladies, particularly the moms, just a moment, and wives. How many say, Pastor, I know that this is a wicked society. I know that this is a crazy world. I know that this culture is not conducive to child rearing. And I'm asking you to pray for me, that I'll have the faith of a Jochebed in the midst of wickedness, to let go and let God. Listen to me, moms, you all will admit your nature is to hold on, because that child was attached to you. But there comes a time when you got to give it to God. Amen. How many of you today would say, ladies, Pastor, pray for me. God's spoken to me. I want that to be true of me like it was of her. Hands all over the building. God bless you. My soul, bless you. God bless you, ladies. And how many of you ladies would say that this thing of letting go and letting God is more real than we could even describe? Would you say amen? Yeah. Some of you are in a situation right now where your performance has peaked. You've done all you can. Now let God's providence step in. I wonder if there's anybody in the building say, Pastor, I'm not sure if I died today. I'd go to heaven, but I'm sure I don't want to go to hell. Please pray for me. Man, woman, boy, or girl, I'm not sure if I died today, I'd go to heaven, but I'm sure I don't want to go to hell. Pray for me. Would you raise your hand? Anybody like that? Anybody? Anybody, let me pray for you. Anybody? I wonder if there's anyone in the building, not just our women, but anyone in the building would say, Pastor, there's some situations in my life where Jochebed can help me. Yeah, she's being an example. I've got some things in my life right now, Pastor, where I have to let go and let God, and I need prayer about that. Would you slip your hand up? Yes, God bless you. God bless you. All of you. Father, touch every single person. And may your word today be a challenge to point others to you, all of us. We read these Bible stories and we can't begin to fathom how difficult it must have been for a mother to place a newborn baby in the river. You've got to be a fool or full of faith to do it. Moses' story shows us just how much faith she had. Honor your people and give us the heart to have the faith to trust you. We love you. We bless you. We magnify you. In Jesus' name, amen. Hebrews says this, by faith Moses, when he was born, was hid 3 months of his parents because they saw he was a proper child and they were not afraid of the king's commandment. There's a lot of other boys that did die because mamas didn't have enough faith to hide them. Because listen, they were too afraid if they hid them, they'd die. By faith Moses, when he was come to years, refused to be called the son of Pharaoh's daughter. Instead, decided to be called a child of God. The Bible tells us in Hebrews 11 that what she did in Exodus wasn't foolishness, it was faith. And God honored her for it, and every single one of us has been impacted by the life of Moses. To all of the moms here at Crossroads Baptist Church today, thank you for being here. I trust God gives you a great day, and I hope that all of us husbands and sons and daughters and everybody else will spoil you, not just today, but may today be a motivation for the love we should show you every single day. And let me encourage you, it will get tough and it will get challenging, but God understands. God will intervene when you do what you can. Let go and let God. Say it together, let go. God bless you for being here. And to everyone else that's here today, we're thrilled to have you. They'll come with just a few announcements and we'll let you go home. Don't forget your book. For all of our moms and wives that are here and enjoy this day, nothing on live stream tonight at all. Just have a good time enjoying one another. And we'll be here on Wednesday night, for our missions conference. What time? If you're in here today, if you're watching today, come in the building. Wednesday night, Thursday night, Friday. These missionaries helping us do our job. So you be here and be a part of it. To that end, men, I don't need to talk to you. I want the men, if you can come forward afterwards, I'm going to get that, one of our guys get that list for our men's breakfast. Get it in here, and let's let the men come forward up here. If you're going to come to the breakfast this coming Saturday, we'll let you sign up here. We'll make it as accessible as you can for all of the men. It'll be right up here to the platform. Let's get as many men. We got it catered. It'll be a wonderful time this coming Saturday at 8:30. Between now and the next time we get together before they come, please know it's your pastor. I miss you, I love you, and I'm praying for you.
Let's stand as we say our theme. 2024, more and more. 2024, more and more. Men, the list is up here. God bless you. Have a wonderful day. Happy Mother's Day.
Hi, folks. I'm Pastor Kenny Baldwin. Thank you for tuning in to the services at Crossroads Baptist Church. I hope in some way it was a blessing to your heart. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel or follow us on Facebook and Instagram. We'd love for you to keep up with what's going on at Crossroads Baptist Church. He's at work, and we're thrilled that you're a part of it. May God bless you.